Sean, I mean, I guess like every fight, the next fight is the biggest fight, right? I mean, that's the way the career goes. But I mean, does this feel like a big moment in your career?
Yeah, it definitely does, especially not being here for a little bit, you know, having two fights fall off and then that injury I had. So I'm just super happy to be here. I'm cutting weight and everything always sucks, but I'm enjoying every single part of this. You know, my entire training camp, I enjoyed every single session, everything about it, every run. I was just super grateful to be back. You know, there was a point I was in the hospital. I couldn't walk, and I thought I was going to lose my foot. And me, my fiance, my mom, we were pretty scared, but luckily everything worked out, and I'm just super fortunate to be here, and I'm excited.
So obviously that infection was crazy. So I mean, you thought you were going to lose the foot. So was there a moment that you accepted that like my fighting career is over, and maybe even think more than that? Like, I mean, that changes your entire life, right?
Yeah. Well, at that point, I mean, I was honestly like, fuck the fight, like, fuck fighting. I'm going to lose my foot. I'm never going to be able to walk. I literally couldn't get out. I was in the hospital for a week. Every time I would stand up, the pain I would feel, it was excruciating. I literally couldn't walk. So I was more concerned about that, you know. But then obviously, like, I'm just laying there, and I'm already someone who's super grateful for what I do. And I'm just like, man, like, I just can't wait to get back in the gym. Like, all I want to do is train. All I want to do is run. Like, so, and then even for a little bit after that, I had a PICC line in my arm. So it took me a little, like, I wasn't allowed to do too much, but I had an Aerodyne in my bike. And like, when my fiance wasn't home, I was crushing workouts on it because I wasn't supposed to be sweating or anything. And I was like, fuck it. Like, I got to work out. So yeah, man, I'm happy, and I'm happy to be here.
So it was only when she wasn't home because she wouldn't let you exercise?
Eventually, she couldn't do anything about it. She would come down and I'd be on the bike, and she just was like, she would just shrug her shoulders and be like, she knows how I am. I'm crazy. So she accepts it.
Yeah. I guess at the risk of sounding cheesy or whatever, I mean, has that made like the hard sessions, like not hard anymore? Like, I mean, do you have like a newfound appreciation for the fact you're able to do it?
I would say, yeah, but I've always just appreciated it. I will say, like, being, like, getting closer to the fight, cutting weight, like, I would always be miserable doing that. And now I just enjoy it, you know. Even, like, before that, I'm like, man, I have the best job in the world. I got to cut a little bit of weight. I got to be a little grump. But I eat clean all year round, so my weight cuts aren't too crazy. So I'm just enjoying it all, man. I'm super grateful, and I enjoy everything about it.
That's awesome. All right, so the matchup with Chiesa, I mean, I know what a fight fan you are. I mean, is this a guy that you enjoyed watching competing?
Yeah, I've been watching Chiesa for forever, you know. So it's super cool to be able to be here and know I'm going to fight him. And I'm super excited to show my skills versus his.
Is it a guy that you thought about fighting in the past? Like, did you ever, you know, kind of think, oh, how would I match up with that guy and that sort of thing?
Once he moved up to 170, and I seen after he beat Neil and he beat RDA, I'm like, damn, he's going to be a player at 170. This is definitely a guy I would like to test myself. And after I fought Jake, I was asking for the fight, but he was on a nice run. So I knew realistically I wasn't going to get it. But then when he lost to Luque, I'm like, all right, it's a possibility. And when they came with it, with the name, we were all over it.
What do you make of him, that last setback, right? I mean, here he is, a stud grappler, and he gets caught, like, in a quick exchange. I mean, what did you take out of that?
It's a crazy sport, man. You can go from being on top, and then 1 second later, you're caught in a submission. So I just got to know that I have to be super present for 15 minutes, and this is my fight to win.
Nice. The hype has been building behind you for a long time, and I know you're used to it. But have you started to think about, I know you can't get ahead of this fight, but, I mean, you beat Michael Chiesa, like, there's only a handful of names up there at the top, right? I mean, have you started thinking about what comes next?
Not really. I mean, I see there's all kinds of names that people are super hype about in the welterweight division right now that I'm gonna show who I am on Saturday night, and then I'll let everybody do the talking for me.
Well, you know, the one name that's going to get thrown out there is Hamzat, right? I mean, he hasn't got a matchup yet. I mean, is that a fight that you feel like the UFC is going to try to make, or do you think it's one that maybe should wait a little while, right? You got two undefeated guys. Maybe it would mean a little more down the road. What do you think?
I mean, they can let us peak, or they can let us crash into each other whenever they want. So I'm not scared of anybody. You know, he's good, but I'm fucking good. So I'll fight anybody in this division. I got business to handle Saturday night, and then we'll take care of that later.
Nice. All right, last thing for me, I do want to ask, like you said, you got to be present for 15 minutes. So what kind of fight do you think we see? I mean, you guys are two stud grapplers. Is this going to be like a great one for the grappling dorks out there, or is this going to be like two grapplers that just end up banging it out because the grappling cancels out?
Man, I don't know. I think I got really good striking, and I'm excited to show that striking, but we're definitely going to get into some grappling exchanges, and I'm going to come out on top.
Hey, Sean. How does it feel to share a card with Pat Sabatini?
It's my boy, man. I'm stoked. The last fight, it would have been me, Pat, and my teammate Andre, who just got signed. So it would have been three of us. I grew up fighting for Cage Fury and fighting in Atlantic City and in Philly. We'd have like five, six guys. It'd be me, Paul Felder, Jonathan Webb, Jared Gordon, all these guys. I love that atmosphere. So I'm super excited to have Pat here, and I'm super excited for his fight. Pat's a beast, man, and people are going to find out.
Yeah, he is. I don't know if you've noticed, but you and Michael have tattoos that kind of conflict.
He
has a tiger on his chest, and you have a guy that's grabbing a tiger.
Yeah, it's – hey, we're going to see. We're gonna see. It is pretty funny, though. Dude, I have nothing but respect for Michael Chiesa. He's a super tough fighter. It's hilarious that those are that. He's got a super good submission game. I got a super good submission game. We're going to see who wins.
And then another thing about tattoo. How long did your back piece take?
It's not even done, and it takes forever. I try to get tattooed as much as I can after I fight, and I would get tattooed and train like the next day. Sometimes even that night I'd go train just because that's what I do. I'd rather suffer the pain than miss training. But now, since I had that staph infection, I'm a completely different person. Like, I'll get tattooed now, and I'm going to have to wait it out. I don't mess around with shit like that anymore. So I actually have an outline of something Japanese on my butt. My tattoo artist won't tattoo anything else until we finish that. So my birthday is the 23rd of this month. I'm getting that finished the 24th, and then we'll see what happens after that.
Nice little birthday present.
Yeah, nice painful birthday present.
What is your favorite tattoo?
My favorite tattoo, I think it might have to be, I got this leopard on the back of my head now. It stands out pretty good, so I think that's one of my favorites. But they all have different stuff, so I love them all.
Thank you.
Thank you.